Hey Margot, great to see you. Your nomination for Best Supporting Actress.
Give me that shit, Ricky! I'm never gonna win anything! I'm a mouthy blonde, and that hasn't ever got us anywhere in this town except the morgue!
Graduating class of the Empty Space Actors Studio, I am Tyrone J. Mansfield. Story four. Four stunningly attractive women, all of them hot, but intelligently hot, rush, because they are late for something or another, into an elevator. One of them, as often happens, has a loaded gun and a shark in her purse. One of the women farts loud and long. This is more than mystery. This is sexy and suspenseful. And this is a Hollywood picture. Get your headshots ready, kids. It's time for your close-up. Here we go. Teeth take to that.
Straight from drama school to the real world. What are you going to do with yours, Margaret? I think I'm going to get headshots for the casting people. Ooh, and a down payment on one of those little bijou Hollywood flats. If I play the role of the star. You're going to be a writer. You could write me a leading role.
Memento mori, a reminder of death from another life.
Enchanté, Margot. One day, all these air kisses werden sich in einen Sturm verwandeln und blasen uns alle weg.
She says one day all these air kisses in Hollywood will become a storm and blow us all away. Fincher wanted me to give you this, his card.
Oh. you're Betty.
And you must be Miss St. Clair. It is Miss St. Clair, isn't it?
In all my living glory, baby.
Pleased to meet you.
He's my ex-husband.
It's written all over that pretty face of yours!
You came here to be an actress? I'll just hope you'll remember, there's never been a great poem called Tits and Ass. It's really an apartment, but we call it a bungalow. Moved in there, he was a stone man. He built himself a big, enormous bath. All those showers made him feel dirty, rainy, rainy, filthy. Need to bathe or not, clean all the showers away. I threw in there a few copies of Variety.
Mac and cheese.
With your extra, extra cheese.
That's right, Rogering. As God is my witness, Mr. High and Mighty, I'm upon my Mount Olympus with my 3 Oscars and 5 Golden Globes and Palme d'Or director, Fincher Nolan. I've single-handedly reinvented all the genres, popular genres of Hollywood with my metaphysical spin and sold them as blockbuster popcorn films. It takes my last bag of cheese with extra, extra cheese, which was also the last bag of cheese with any cheese on that motherfucking day.
Oh, dummy!
Tish, tish!
Quel fromage!
Boys? Donnie, Bumpy, Dodgering, Sneaker.
Mr. Nolan, sir.
Okay. Now you can see Mr. Nolan in the monitor.
Yes, I can.
Good. Now you understand that this device you're in is meant to make you appear weightless.
Oh, my dear.
On an intense lesbian relationship with a woman several years your senior, and at this time of heightened emotion and sexual excitation, I'd like to set out a few simple rules.
Rule one, everything you say or do in this room is strictly in confidence.
No!
I think this is all very straightforward and very normal, and a few sessions with me will help to alleviate this very straightforward trauma that causes sleep problems and mild hallucinations.
And you are the woman. Abundance is yours for the taking, and none other is impossible. Everything you desire will be yours.
You've been lying. He's been a white bathrobe, sir. Yes, sir. Sir.
Mr. Stein feels at any point your intimacy is being compromised, then the room will be sealed off, and you will be isolated and taken into immediate
emergency intimacy care.
Margot, you were somewhat inside out.
I just needed.
What did you need, Margot?
I just needed some support.
Margot!
Do you want to be taken in for your own care and safety?
Do you? Or...
are you the girl?
Yes. I am the girl.
Good.
Come on, my friend, wait a second!
dare you ask who I am? I am Krimhild, the extraordinary and beautiful Queen of Worms. What's this Hollywood? I've never heard of it. I will invade and vanquish it. And I may take you, deposed queen, as my servant in charge of leading my arse once I've had my morning shiza.
How fucking dare you?
No, how fucking dare you? You flabby candid afterbirth.
Skanky cum dumpster.
My dear dead Brunhild called me skanky.
Oh, wait, no. Oh, wait. I'm sorry.
Yes, okay. I also spoke harshly.
There's this driver called Tucker Longhorn. He says he is to take you to the Golden Globes. Oh, and you won Best Supporting Actress.
I am Margot Monroe, and the time for revolution, cultural revolution, has arrived. All you, the great and the deplorable of Hollywood, will want to make smaller, more independent films with complex postmodern storylines where time loops back on itself, and have more diverse roles with people of all colors, sexual orientations, and identities, and women characters that have fully rounded backstories, healthy sexual appetites, and who can fart whenever the fuck they want. And this act will bring an end to the collective dream nightmare that has held sway over the world's imagination for far too long.
None of this is real.
What do you mean none of this is real? You know the story I wrote.
Imagine, if you will, imagination dead. On the night of January 5th, 2020, at 7:17, a black hole, originally created for genius film director Fincher Nolan's masterpiece, Black Hole, escaped the airplane it was being transported on, and lodged itself above the bungalow of deceased author Philip K. Dick. The exact moment the black hole appeared, all human imagination evaporated.
Imagination dead. Imagine. But there was one man who knew he could profit from this. Disgraced movie mogul, Hal Stein. There is only one obstacle to Hal Stein's plan for world domination. And that is Margot Monroe.
Go!
Welcome to the dark.
Mental asylum for once great stars.
Dr. Professor Mr. Fincher-Nola.
Fincher-Nola, I know him. He's a director. I worked with him on The Black Hole.
That may be, but... Since the world's imagination evaporated,
there is no need for big blockbuster movies.
And Fincher-Nolan is now director of the Institute.
You are under the care of Dr. Nolan now. And there are only two ways out.
The first is through that door. And the second
is up. And there is only one reason why you would need to go that way. Ooh.
You have been brought here for your own protection. Suffering from... rehearsal syndrome.
First, Margot. We'll call her Margaret.
I
seems to be suffering from 1950s melodrama syndrome.
Oh my. However could it be?
Margot, too. We'll call her Maggie. Seems to be suffering from 1970s gritty realist syndrome.
Fuck you, you motherfucking cocksucker!
And the third Margot. We'll call her Little Margot. The teensy tiny though I am blind, I see, is drowning in her own sorrow. It is Little Margot we must save from drowning, or else.
The other Margot.
Yes. just humans.
Donnie!
Make sure the trope is in working order, Donnie.
Sure is.
Lovely.
Oh, cut the horse shit. I haven't got time for this. Is Bona available?
Mademoiselle Blanche, I'm afraid he isn't available. You'll have to call his agent.
No fucking agent! Just get here. We need to make some cuts around the Marco Monroe story. We need to cut around the
inevitable.
The inevitable.
No problem, Marcel.
Alice, then get the fuck on with it.
Coping.
Good. I'm glad.
Listen, it's me. Can you hear me?
Yeah. I hear you. No need to be so loud. How can RADA Studios help you?
We have a stiff problem on our hands. We need to handle immediately. Alice Guy Blanche.
Oh. Mademoiselle Blanche. You know she makes everything. This is hard.
She is a tough director, but upon her, Mademoiselle Blanche wants us to cut around a plot inevitability. Margot Monroe is in grave peril.
Margot Monroe is in grave peril.
Margot Monroe is in grave peril.
I am all ears.
Donnie, fetch the broad. Fetch Margot Monroe.
It's time to get into her little lady head.
They're so good! They're Sinclair. Get Margot!
Donnie, what the fuck is Margot talking about? Donnie, what the fuck is she talking about?
Remember the new crew.
Speak up, Donnie. I can't hear you.
Remember Yi Poo, the cinematographer.
You might look at me. You might look at me and think, look at her. Look at her face. Look at her eyes. Look at her mouth. Look at her. I made her. I made her. Well, you didn't. Because you never truly saw me. You never saw the darkness or the light inside of me. No, no, Fincher, there is nothing
This is not just a figment of your imagination. Vision. There is no script, Fincher. You can't cut the action because I am doing the action.
There is nothing to cut anymore. There is no script. There are no actions. This is me. This is... You can't rewrite my words because I am saying them right here, right now. My imagination. These are my words.
And I am speaking for Queen Brimhilda, who died avenging her blood.
Queen of the Nibelungens, who died avenging her lover. Speak in the voice of Alice Guy Blanchard, the first female director. And I am speaking. I am speaking for Yi Fu. My love. My lover. My dead lover, whose imagination I see. There is nothing to cut, Fincher, because I am whole again. I am Margot Monroe. I do not need your permission.
Yes, Mr. Stein. Yeah. The trouble. There'll be no trouble, sir, I can assure you. Okay, Mr. Stein. Yes, Mr. Stein.
Jean Bonner, did you change the inevitable?
Mademoiselle, we're trying!
Fucking do it! Fucking do it!
We're trying!
Do it!
Game are to do. I come.